and also for the negative. So after that, we take the ratio here. Separation is just like the distance. And the final step, we calculate the relative the closeness to the ideal solution. So when C here closes with 1, it means it's very close with the best, is the best one, right? So okay, right now I'll give you example here. I want you to follow step by step we're working on for this example. Okay, let's go. Right now, we define that selecting a car under 4 criteria: style, reliability, fuel economic, operation research, and operation cost. And here, that is the alternative. So the number they give you in this, just the raw score, not normalized yet. So go with first step. Everyone, I want you to practice that. So how we can normalize this table? Based on the step here, step one, normalize score. You should do it by yourself. Don't look at the next slide. Hello. So I will ask the student that they check that you understand what I'm talking about. Ngô Văn Hiếu. Hello, Hiếu.
Yes, teacher, I'm here.
So do you know how to normalize this table?
I'm not so clear about it yet.
So what happened in your computer? Do you know how to do that? I've just asked you understand the way you do that one. Do you know how to do that? How to normalize this table? Please, Hugh. Can you hear me? Yeah, but my question is, you know how to normalize this table or not? So everyone, if you don't know about how to normalize this, so just let me know. Okay, so before you normalize this one, you must to do what? You must to define here which one that is the benefits, which one is the benefits criteria, which one is the cost criteria, right? So, okay, let me ask another student. Fuel economies, do you think that is the best, the benefits or the cost criteria? Let me ask student. Võ Ngọc Kim Châu. Hello, Châu. Yeah. We think fuel economy, that is benefits criteria.
I think the risk service and food is has more benefits.
That is
I'm sorry, it's my husband, some noise.
Yes. So that is the cost benefits, or that is the cost criteria or benefits criteria? So everyone, just let me know that is the cost or that is the benefits. You can leave me your answer in the chat box.
And then it is the benefit attributes.
Yeah. Yes, that is the benefits, because higher is the better, right? Higher is the better. And operation cost, of course, that is the cost benefits. So right now we define that 1, 2, 3, that is the benefits criteria, and operation cost, that is the cost criteria. So if you aware that, so you can do the normalization. So who can let me know the way you normalize? Jason Technis?
I think yes, we are introduced 4 methods in the previous class. So based on what we have, and so we can use it.
Yeah.
We can use the max, the mean, the sum, or the max mean.
Yeah. Okay, that's right. So we can select one of them. But in here, so I just list down one technique for you. You can pay on that to calculate normalize. Thank you very much, Wang Wen. And if you look at this, so you can see that we normalize them by 7, you divide for all of the row here. The column here. I take 7 square, 8 square, 9 square, and 6 square, and I square root, and I take each of them to divide for sum. So I get the result here. For example, I take example 1 for the column 1. I get 0.46, and you do the same, so you can fill all the table here. Okay, after you have the normalization, so you text this score, you time with the weight, right? This score time with weight. So you will have the new table here. So after you have the new table, you must define the ideal solution. So look at this ideal solution. It means that you can look at the style. You see that 0.59, that is the largest one. So you select that is ideal. So for reliability, you select the highest one. Fuel economy, highest one. But operation cost, you should select the lowest one, right? So you have the ideal solution. The separation. Separation is mean, for example, here is ideal, right? We minus for each one, 0.04 from this table. Because we take different between ideal with each alternative under each criteria. And after that, we make the square and we take sum and we take the square root. So we will have for the ideal, the separation of the ideal solution here. The same for the negative ideal solution, we do the same way. We have the separation. So from the separation, negative and positive, so we take the ratio. Here you take the ratio. So this is the highest one. It means that is the closest with the ideal solution and far with the negative ideal solution. So we can select which one is the best one. Right, it's the best. Any question for me? Any question for me, everyone? No? So it's clear, right? So no one respond me. Is this clear, everyone? So let's meet.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yes. So I will give you another example and I want to practice on that. Is it okay? For you to practice. Here I have just writing 1, 2, 3. So one, the weight is 0.3, and 0.2. Here that is criteria, but that is the cost. So we have A1, A2, and A3. Here that is the weight. Okay. So here is 7, 5, 4, 6, 3, 5, 4, 4. So I hear so I'm asking you to find which one that is the best one using top six. So the first step, we do normalization, right? Okay. So do normalization first. Okay, everyone, you know how to normalization, right? So let me ask another student. Let me add a student. Trần Thiên Kim. Hello, Kim.
Yes, teacher.
Yeah. So can you normalize this table for me?
Yes. I will read the number for you. A1, it is 0.5.
Yeah, no, I want to know the way you do.
Yes. First,
I take some rules.
Yes. And it equals
So here,
okay.
I just write that is sum.
Yes, the sum is 138.
Okay, everyone, I'm writing a way for everyone to follow that. Sum is mean, I'm taking 7, 5, and 8. Okay, so what is for this column? This column will be the same. Okay.
Yes.
After we normalize, so what we do next, we will have the new table, right? I have a new table. So you, for example, sum one, column one. Here you divide for sum two, right? Divide for sum two. Yeah, of course you can use max. Yeah. You don't want to use sum, you can use max, it's okay. But you must to write out the formula. You can divide from it. It's okay. So here, stop. Right, the same. After you normalize, what you do next? What you do next, everyone? For step two, look at the step two. The step two, we take this. This is, we call that in a V, V-I-K. Look at the slide in the step two. Here. So step two, you have WI, you have VIJ, so you multiply. So here you multiply for 0.3. It says 0.3, you multiply 0.3. Here is 0.5 times. That's the same, right? So we will have V's. So right now, that will become V's, right? All of this here is become V's. V-I-J. V-I-J. In the previous is R. This one is R. R time with W become V's. Vij will be equal to Rij times width. So here that the Rij is Vi. Vj, here's Vj. Right? That is step two, everyone. So for step three, so I ask another student. Yes, it's Jane, Kui Jane.
We determine the ideal and negative ideal.
Yeah, so how we can divide the ideal? Yeah, if we look at it.
We choose the max for the benefits and choose the minimum.
Now look at this one. Which one is the max?
For C1A3, yes.
This one is the maximum, right?
Yes.
So we will have 0.3 times A divided by some square one. Right? And another?
A2.
Yes, here. 0.9. This right times 6 and other here it should be 5, right? 5 times 0.2 divided by some. Am I correct?
I think the C3 is the cost, so we should choose the smallest.
4, right? Because 4 that is the smallest. Not here should be select 4, everyone. Here is 0.2, right? 0.2. And 0.2. And divide for sum 3 square, right? Here also sum. So this is smallish. And we define negative, right? Negative, we select what? Here, smallish, 0.3 times with 5 divided for some 1. Here, you choose that this one, 0.5 times 3 divided for some 2. And 5 times 0.5. You divide for some 3, right? So after you have this one, so what you should do next? What you should do next, everyone?
We should calculate the separation.
Yeah, calculate the separation. Separation is mean we take this one, you minus this, right? Take this, minus this. The same for each column. And after that, we take some of them, right? You look at the slide here. We see we take the different, take the square, and after that, we take some of each one. And after that, we have S, the ideal solution, right? Separation from the ideal solution. And here, you use the negative, you take different, take different, take different. And you take sum, you will have the negative. And finally, you take here. Finally, you take the ratio. So that's all. Do you have any other question for me? Do you have any question? It's easy and clear, right? It's straightforward. Tao Phạm. Hello, Tao.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, any question for me?
No. I don't have any question.
Okay. It means you understand, right?
Yes.
You have no question? If we have no question, so we take the break and after that we continue. Take the 15-minute break. And after that, we continue with the top six, okay? So during the break, have any questions, so leave the question in the chat box, and I will answer you later. Okay. Hello. Hello, hello. Hello, everyone. So, finish this lesson. Any question for me? If you don't have the question, so I have a question for you. Hello, everybody here. So, could you update a slide on the blackboard? So that is the slide on the blackboard. You didn't see that? Hi, hello, hi. You don't.
Slide trên BB chỉ mới tới cái slide số 21 rồi cô.
It's right, it's just 221 slide. So here that is a different methods. Here different methods. So I'm cut that because I don't want before I combine all the lesson in one slide, but right now I cut that. Each chapter, each methods. So it is correct. It's nothing wrong.
Teacher, can I have a question?
Yeah, sure.
Hello.
Yeah.
Can you turn back to the slide number
18?
Yes,
this one.
Yes. In the formula, we take the Vj plus minus to the Vij But I see that the VJ is equal to 0.059 and the VIJ is equal to
zero.
Yes. I mean, it's the...
Yeah, that's fine, because we, even that is zero, but we take some of them, you know, that we take some of them from here to here. So the value is not zero, right? Even this zero, so that is...
I mean, when you calculate the first one, the V1
here, right?
Yeah, yes. And for the civics, the VJ plus is equal to 0.059 and the V11 is equal to 0.
So it's my mistake here, right? Let me see. It's, the maximi of this is maximi, right? So I minus this one is equal to zero. It's correct. This one is correct.
Không, còn ý em là cái VJ sao đó, ở cái đầu tiên đó không? Cái VJ sao nó là bằng 0.059 trừ cho 0.046, như nó bị ngược đúng không cô?
Nhưng mà mình square nó mà em đâu có quan trọng gì đâu.
Đúng
rồi. Ngoài cái này nó bằng nhau rồi mình square nó họ đâu ý nghĩa đâu, có gì đâu sai đâu. Được không?
Yes, thank you.
Mình square nó thì ý nghĩa nó không có gì sai đâu. Trước hay sau gì cũng được. Chủ yếu ở đây của mình là mình đang so sánh, mình phải hiểu là mình đang so sánh nó với cái star đó. Mình so sánh nó với cái star thì nó là distance. So any other question?
No, thank you, teacher.
So everyone. So right now I have a like experience when teaching online. So I try to finish the classes like in two periods, and I left one period for you to answer the question and discuss. It's better if I just teach all the three periods. It's no time for you to have the question and answer section.
Dạ cô, em có một câu hỏi được không ạ?
Được, sure.
Dạ, ở slide số 5 đó ạ.
Slide số 5.
Ồ dạ, hình như là cái slide trong cái file cô
gửi lên. Cái file là nó không có chia chính đúng không? Nó không có chia cho chính đúng không? Tại vì không có chia cho chính đó là chưa có normalize. Thì khi mà cô giảng bài, cô để ở đây cho các bạn dễ nhìn chú ý hơn, là tại ban đầu là mình cho cái score, sau đó mình phải chia. Cái này là cô đánh thêm vào trước khi cô dạy, là cô đánh thêm vào. Dạ. Chia chính là chia cho cái max. Cái max này là chính này các bạn. Thì cô chia cho chính. Được không?
Dạ dạ.
Ừ. Là mình đã normalize đó, một cái step normalize. Còn để luôn kia thì không có normalize.
Rồi, cảm ơn cô.
Okay. Any other questions? So, if you don't have the question, so man, I have the question for you. So what happens if like we have a lot of criteria? So for example, here when we make the decision, but we think that if we have the class, a lot of criteria for comparison. So is this possible for top six? Because it's, no one asked me that question. So for example, here I give you like three criteria. If I have like early criteria, so top six still work. So what do you think?
Yes, teacher. Can I?
Yeah.
I think it will not work well. We just need some main criteria to calculate. I mean, you need the sum of the weight is about 90%. Yes, like this. If the order is too small, we needn't to calculate them. We just choose the big one. Yeah.
So it means we just select the main criteria, right?
Yes, teacher.
That is the more like effect to selecting. That is your mean. So it's right. It's your right. You're right. So everyone, when we make the comparison, when we make we select the criteria, we should select that just main criteria. Of course, you know that if we have more criteria, is like can maybe we think that we have like the more accurate, right? Because you pay on more criteria, you think that is, but it actually is not. Even though that is important, but when we select, we think about what we pay on. So we just select the main thing. So, but the question is, if my criteria, I think that I have 10 criteria important. So is this okay for me to use the top six? So if 30 is too much, right? But right now, what about 10? Hello. Have any idea, everyone?
I think 10 is okay.
So why you think that 10 is okay?
Because these you said that the main criteria.
Yeah, but what about 11? 11 just like over 1. It's more than 10 is 1. So 9, 10, 11. What about 11? So is any idea? Everyone, do you have any idea? Can I cannot?
I'm cuddling. I think maybe we should consider the weight because some criterion will have more weight than the other. So we can choose which set of criterion will make the most weight, like maybe 80 or 90% of the weight will be attributed to like five or six criteria, let's say. Because it's rarely the case when 10 criteria have the same weight. It's only my opinion.
Yeah, so for example, it's not the same, but the similar. What about similar? Similar weight, I have 10, 11 criteria have like similar weight. It's not, I don't mention about the same, but it's similar, just... Approximately the same. So that we can still do this method.
Well, I think if the weight like is similar, maybe we can combine them because of equal importance.
Yeah, the combine is also the one idea, but I don't want the combine. Is can I use optics?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think I need to think over that.
So in here, I just want I raise some open question, and I encourage you to think about that. Any other idea, everyone? I don't know for Google Meet we can break the room or not. Let me add the TA. So next time I hope I can give you like I'm breaking many room for you to discuss. Okay, so let me discuss about this. For top six, so and I already mentioned about the generals. It means we just focus on main criteria when we select or we make the decision. But if right now we have much, we have like 10, we have over nine criteria. So we should think about that, which one is less important. Because what? Because they have like the research related with the psychologies. If we consider, if we make pairwise comparison, it's like over the 9 criteria. So it means we have 9-9 matrix, right? 9-9 matrix. So you give the score is inconsistent, not correct. So what is inconsistent here? For example, if you give score A greater than B, B greater than C, but when you give the score C and A, so maybe confused if you have more than 9. So in here, they didn't mention about that, but I want to share with you that they have the research about that. So this is applied for
AHV method. So for next class, I'm going to share with you about this lesson. So here, remember when we solve the very complicated problem, but you should select just 9. If it's a lot of criteria, maybe you can combine them one. And another thing I want to say with you that, for example, when we talk about the style, I give you the style here, but what exactly is style? So no one asked me that. So can you measure style, everyone? And for reliabilities, yes, is Kanlen? Kanlen? Okay. You raise your hands, right?
I have a little confusion about slide number 5, but I think we could talk about that after you have explained. I don't want to cut you off.
Okay. For style. So what exactly the style? When you make the compare, when you select the criteria, so you must to define that. For example, when we talk about the style, I actually don't know what exactly the style. Style, you can like give the definition of style like appearance or color or screen. That is the style. But when we just say the style, it's not correct. So in here, you may have the sub criteria, or you can reply that by exactly what the criteria like, right? Directly the color or appearance. Or if you consider both style and appearance, so you can write like the sub criteria. For reliabilities also. So what exactly is reliability here? So when we talk about that is kind of quality, it's not quantitative. Qualitative here, it's not quantitative. We cannot measure that. But cost is, we can measure, right? We can measure, it's exactly how much money. But reliability, so exactly what is reliability? So when you solve the real problem, you must to clarify each criteria. Okay, that is what I want to say with you, what I want to mention that when you select criteria. So one of the important thing when you use the MADM, when you use MADM technique to solve the problem, that is define criteria and how you get the score here. That is the most important one. So for example, because I give you example here, very simple, that is the personal decision making. But for the real problem, complicated problem, so right now we must to go to find what criteria we should pay on, right? So why we select that criteria? I think it's the most important one. So when you do the thesis also, you must to face with that question. So for example, when we selecting like the supplier also, For example, for supplier, we have many types of supplier. For example, supplier like during the COVID here, so how we can select is the criteria will different with like we don't have the COVID, right? COVID-19. So each case we have different criteria. So you must to persuade them why we need to pay off. I think it's tough. It's more important. Even though you see that the step for make the decision is very simple, right? So straightforward. You don't think too much. You just like apply that to serve. But I mentioned that more important here that it define the criteria. And another thing I want to share with you that so I forgot. This is just I have an idea I want to share with you. When you do with okay, another thing. You don't have like when you select the criteria for solve the real problem. So the criteria we select that under like we have several alternatives. So several alternatives, but like this, some students they have like this. So for example, A. You have C1, C2, C3. So you have A1, A2, and A3. This is eight, that is 6, 7, maybe 5, is 9, 3, 4, not here is 6. A6. Okay. They give the score like this. But you see that it's not, that is incorrect. So why is incorrect? Because when we make the comparison, so A1, A2, A3 is non-dominant. Non-dominant. But you look at this, is A1 is obviously dominant A2 and A3. You see, each criteria is dominant. So, if dominant, you don't need to put it here. Everyone, what I mean? Because if you just look at this, we will know A1 is the best. You don't need to make any comparison. We definitely sure that is A1 is the best. So this is not correct if you put A1 in here. You must to put like something like this. Maybe the same, that is over than this one, that is larger than, sorry, here it should be like 7. Better. So something is better, something that are worse. So remember that when you select that, do the thesis, you must to check the score when the expert they give here. So in the real problem, it's not only the criteria you must define, you also define the alternative, right? So like here, if you put, you just randomly choose, you can see that is incomparable, obviously dominant. So for top six, here I'm just give you like very basic topics methods. So until now, they already improved the topics. They use like fuzzy topics, different types of fuzzies. So we have like interval fuzzy, we have like hesitant fuzzy, we have like intuition. It's many types of fuzzy. So for what they want to improve, they want to support for decision make like accurate the decision. So actually, because in the real life, we don't use like, when we give the evaluation, we don't use like the number. So you just say, oh, it's good, it's nice, it's beautiful. So like this. So how can we measure that? How can we transform that become the numerics? So when we said like beautiful, warm, cool, that is just the linguistic variable. Linguistic value is, but the human, they like to use that rather than they say that is, today is 35 degrees. They just say today is hot, right? So they think about that, they propose the fuzzy number can represent for crib number. Crib number is like real number here. So when you do the thesis, you just like pay on just only crib number is not enough for the thesis work loss. So you must to do more research on this. And right now we have different version of topic right now. I don't know how many, maybe 1,000. And also so for solving each problem, maybe they can add some techniques inside. But what I'm sharing with you here, that is the basic, from the basic. So if you want to research more about the topic so you can understand. Okay, that is all my sharing. So what are your questions, Lynn?
Yeah, I want to ask about slide number 5. The cost column, the cost criteria, when I use the formula in slide number 3, I don't come up with the same numbers. Like my number is 8 over 9, 8 over 8, and 8 over 8 all over to the bottom. Like, because I consider it a cost criteria, so I use the formula in the slide or the formula, the mean of the column divided by the value, the x ij value in the cell.
So I understand your question. So as I mentioned earlier, we have two ways. The first, I treat cost like benefits. It's not like cost. So for example, see this here, they sell like what, $90. Example, the cost we must pay here, that is 80s. Here is 80s. For example, that is the same because here the same $80. Example. So what 90 here? I still give the score is 9. Right. And 8 is lower, I give the score is lower. Sorry, here is 80. Sorry, here is 80, that is 90. Sorry,
is 90. So it means that if I already put the score here, is the lower is the better. So it means the service here, I give the score, the high score. I give 9. So for the Saturn, I give 8. Here I give 8. 8. It means in the score, I already give the score, right? The same with the benefits.
Oh yeah,
you got what I mean.
Yes.
So for example, low, I think low is the better, so I give the score higher. I'm making this. Yes, it's one. It's lower score. I give the high, lower cost, give high score, lower cost, give high score. So high score here is mean high score is the better, right? So I should divide for max. You got what I mean, Lynn?
Yes, thank you. I understand now.
Yeah. So, but in case, in K, you give like 8, 9, 9, so you should divide for 8. Right? So any other question, everyone?
So in this case, you are treating the cost like the benefit, right?
Yeah, so because it's lower is better, so I give better score here. I give better score. I give better score for the low one. So here, I'm just for divide for better, right?
Yes, so so if you treat the cost like a cost, so you will need to use the formula in the slide to achieve.
So for example, right now, I don't know, but I think like that. Let me give the score just like lower score, a high. Here is 18. I give how many if everyone is, if I give 8. So what about, sorry. So here, 9 is 9. But if I apply, the slide in this one, so 1, I divide for x, divide for max is like this. It's 1, I divide for 9, and divide for max is 1, divide for 9. It's everyone. Divide for 8. Sorry. A 1 over A is max, right? So is it different? So here should be A over 9. So, okay, look at this.
if I do is the same in the slide 2. So I take 1 over 9, divide 1 over 8. So this will be equal what? A over 9, right? This will be equal A over 9. Is this everyone? So that is later than 9 over, it's later than 9 over 9, right? So here should be 9 over 8. Here is 9 over 8. So here is 9 over 8. Here is 9 over 8. But if you look at it, so the cost, the low cost is the low cost. But here, the score, the low cost is score is the lower than the high cost. It is not correct, right? The low cost, the score should be higher. So even though you normalize or not normalize, but we still keep that low cost, it should be. Don't confuse with the cost here. So here you give the score, but if you give the 18, if you get directly the cost here, it's different. You got what I mean? If you give like 80s, directly the number of the price here, so it's different. But you pay on that, you give the score. You pay on that, you give the score is different, right? So some problem they write directly here the score they yes. But right now I evaluate the cost based on the score. Pay on the price. So in real problem, some case they write directly like 80, like write directly 80 or 90s. Yes, please.
Hello, miss. Can you explain the score for the civic cost again? I think that should be A over 8.
Yeah, here. Again. So I give that is 18, right? $18 is cheaper. So I evaluate the cost is higher. I evaluate that high score. Right? Actually, right now I want to find something that the car where with the cheaper, right? If the cheaper, that is the advantage, right? So 80s, the cheap.
If we're talking about the cost and not benefit, if we're talking about the cost, then what's the score for this?
Okay, so here I mentioned about the score I evaluate for the price. But if you write the cost, you write directly, for example, 80 here. I give the score 80, $90 directly here. So if we have the number like this, so we normalize by, for example, we divide for max. So here, normalize, we have many ways, but you can take mean. If the cost benefits, you take mean. You divide for, let me see the slide here.
We're keeping the original score that you gave on the table, and if we go back to the slide number three, the second equation for the cost criterion, and I don't know how we do that. Can you explain that again?
Yes. We take max, right? Max of 1/9 and max of 1/8. So we choose 1/8. Compare 1/8 and 1/9. So 1/8 is larger than 1/9, right? So let me write it down in the table here in the board. So we have 9, 8, 8, 8. Right now we take 1/9, 1/8, 1/8, 1/8, right? And after that we select max here. Max will be equal with 1/8, is it? Compare 1/8 and 1/9, we select which one is the max? 1/8. And we have 1/8 here. We divide for max, divide for max, divide for max, divide for max. Okay.
Dạ cô, thật ra em nghĩ là nếu như mình làm theo kiểu kiểu cost thì cái đầu tiên sẽ là 8, là 999, rồi lấy 1/8 chia cho max, là lấy 1/8 chia cho 1/8, vậy tức là cái ô đầu tiên sẽ là bằng 1, những cái ô ở dưới sẽ là 8/9.
8/9, 8/8.
Yes. Ý là cái ô đầu tiên của em là em vẫn để là 8999, sau đó lấy 1/8 chia cho 1/8 bằng 1. Khi mà mình normalize nó.
Không, nếu mà em để cái con số giá tiền á, em để con số giá tiền vô á thì em mới làm như vậy được. Chứ còn bây giờ em đang đánh giá nó mà. Ví dụ như giờ em đang đánh giá nó là 80, nó là tốt, mà em cho nó điểm thấp thì đâu có đúng.
Dạ, ý em là tại vì mình đang coi cái đó như thế, là giống như cost, cái cost mình không coi nó là benefits thì mình sẽ coi nó là cost.
Không, cost thì... đúng, cái đó coi nó giống như cost. Ví dụ như bây giờ em cho nó
thì cost của nó 80 thì mình chấm nó 8 điểm. Thì cost nó 90, mình chấm nó 9 điểm. Nhưng mà do
nhưng
mình
nó là... Khoan, dừng lại chỗ đây. Cost nó 80, em cho nó 8 điểm. Cost nó 90, em cho nó 9 điểm. Thì đâu có đúng.
Dạ, nếu như vậy, ý là nếu như mà mình nó cost nó 80, mình cho nó 9 điểm, thì lúc đó mình đang coi nó là benefit rồi. Nhưng mà giờ mình đang coi nó là cost thôi, thì mình sẽ chấm đúng theo. Ủa? Cái điểm.
Nhưng mà trong cái bảng này em đã thống nhất á, trong cái bảng này đúng không? Tại vì em đâu có phải là em cho một cái criteria ở đâu. Tự nhiên bên này em cho nó là điểm.
Dạ, hai cái đó là benefit, còn cái cuối mình lại là
nó không có đúng, em hiểu không? Bây giờ em đang đánh giá nó nè. Ví dụ như giờ cô đang đánh giá cái reliability nó tốt, đúng không? Thì cô cho nó điểm cao. Bây giờ cô đang đánh giá cái cost của nó tốt, thì cô phải cho nó điểm cao chứ.
Dạ đúng rồi, bởi vì nó bị ngược như vậy nên là mình mới phải dùng cái công thức thứ hai của cost là lấy 1/ ấy ra.
Ok, cô hiểu ý em rồi, nhưng mà ở đây mình vẫn cho nó là phải là cho nó 9 điểm em.
Dạ vậy nếu cho nó...
Nhưng mà khoan, để normalize, có thể cô bị nhầm chỗ normalize.
Dạ.
Nó vẫn là 9 điểm đó. Đã khoan rồi. Cái này cũng như mấy bạn làm cho cô cảm thấy cũng hơi nghi ngờ. Nếu mà nói 9 điểm thì cái đây là 1/9, thì cho 1/8 có nghĩa là 8/9. Hôm trước cái bài kia cô coi thử nè, nó là 8/9 đúng không? Lấy min chia cho cái đó 8/9 thì mấy cái kia là gì?
nếu mà em chia cho 1 phần tặng mấy cái
nhà mấy kia hành 9 phần 8 thì nó lại không đúng, nó lại lớn hơn thì lại không đúng.
Nó không đúng, đúng rồi, nên là cô thấy cái này nó mới đúng nè. Cái này là mình cho nó là 9 điểm đúng không?
Dạ, 9 điểm thì cô đang xem nó là benefit thì cô sẽ chia cho max theo nhất như là công thức đó.
Chứ bây giờ ví dụ như á, cô nói em á, ví dụ ở chỗ này em không có cho khác được. Em đã đánh giá nó là em không có cho khác được. Em không có cho nó 8 điểm chỗ đây được. Nếu mà nó 80 mà cho 90 chỗ đây, em cho nó 8 thì không được, không cho được. Tại vì em đang đánh giá nó mà, em đang đánh giá nó tốt thì em cho vô đây.
Dạ, dạ thì theo nếu như giống như những cái điểm trước cái cột style reliability thì hai cái đó sẽ được xem như benefit thì cái nào càng tốt thì cái điểm càng cao thì cái cost này của mình cũng như vậy, thì cost càng thấp thì điểm càng cao thì lúc đó mình đang consider nó như là một benefit. Nên như vậy lúc đó thì mình sẽ chia cho max giống như công thức bình thường.
Thì cô chia cho chính đó.
Dạ còn, đúng rồi. Dạ còn ý em là cái trường hợp bây giờ mình coi nó là cost theo như bình thường chứ mình không coi nó là benefit thì tức là 8 vẫn là 8 nhưng mà bởi vì
không, em hiểu sai vấn đề rồi. Có nghĩa là nếu trường hợp cái này là cost. Cái cost ở đây em phải hiểu nó là cái gì đã. Ví dụ như cô nói ha, ví dụ như em khi mà em ví dụ như đây là cái điểm đánh giá cho cái việc đó, còn có một cái loại khác nữa, ví dụ như là ok, có cái chi phí bao nhiêu, ví dụ như chi phí này 80 là 80, cái này 90 là 90, em đi ra như vậy á thì nó mới đúng. Em đi cái số tiền ra, ví dụ như cái reliability em không có đánh giá nó ha, ví dụ như reliability, ví dụ như cái chỉ số reliability này là 3, chỉ số reliability này là 4, chỉ số, cái chỉ số thực tế của nó này chứ không phải sự đánh giá nha, chỉ số này là 5, chỉ số này là 7 chẳng hạn như vậy. Cái chỉ số của nó đó, ví dụ như mức độ mà reliability của nó bao nhiêu thì mình ghi ra bấy nhiêu, đó thì là nó khác. Còn ví dụ như mình dựa trên cái này nè rồi mình cho điểm nó đó thì nó lại khác. Có nghĩa là ở đây á, mình có thể normalize nó, mình chuyển cái này normalize nó. Và ví dụ như mình lấy sum cũng được đó. Ví dụ như A, sau khi mình đã chuyển đổi nó là mình lấy 8 mình chia cho mình chia cho cái sum ở dưới đây 8 9 đó, có thể mình là normalize. Còn cái của mình ở đây là em dùng cái max và cái min, thì có thể là ở chỗ đây mình sẽ là mình chọn cái max là mình có 8/9 nè, mình có ở đây là 9/9 nè. Sorry, cái này là phải 8/8 chứ, cái này phải 8/8, cái này là 8/9 nè.
Dạ không, tại vì cái trường hợp này thì em sẽ coi nó là có, thì em sẽ lấy 1/8 chia cho 1/8, còn mấy cái dưới sẽ là 1/9 chia cho 1/8.
1/8 chia cho 1. Dạ. Đâu có đúng.
Vậy dạ không. Đúng. Ý là mấy cái dưới, cái dưới tôi lấy 1/8 chia cho 1/8.
Hay 1/8.
Dạ 1/8 chia cho 1/8.
Thực ra là con chỉ lấy cái này cô chia cho cái min thôi. Thực ra cô lấy từng cái cô chia cho cái min thôi. Tại vì cái công thức ở đây nó để là 1/ x chia cho max của 1/ kia, thì thực tế nó là min chia cho cái xij thôi, min chia cho xij thôi. Cái này là xij chia cho max vậy thôi, chứ đâu cần phải phức tạp. Thì có nghĩa là 8 chia 8 nè, chia cho cái min, rồi mình lấy cái 9 này mình chia cho 8, đúng không? Cô làm đúng không các bạn? Hay là 8 chia 9
Dạ đúng rồi cô.
89 đúng không? 89 đúng không? Cái này là chia cho max. Nhưng mà cái này là cái cost thì mình chia cho min. 1/8 chia cho 1/8 ha. Hay là 1/9 chia cho 1/8. 1/9 chia cho 1/8. Đó. Nếu mà mình coi nó là ví dụ mình cho cái số tiền mình chi phí bao nhiêu mình ghi vô trong ngày luôn á. Thì khi mà mình normalize của nó ra cái số tiền cái mình ngay cả mình normalize của nó nhưng mà mình cũng vẫn phải đánh giá của nó giống như vậy thôi chứ không có khác.
Dạ vâng, thật ra ý là ý em là thật ra nó là hai cách normalize thôi nhưng mà kết quả nó vẫn là giống như cái kết quả theo như cách kia ấy ạ. À, nó cũng giống như cô để 9/9 rồi 8/9, 8/9, 8/9. À, bây giờ mình ngược lại thôi.
Khi mà mình normalize xong mình phải check lại coi thử mình có làm đúng không nha. Ví dụ như ở đây mình cho nó là 9 điểm đúng không? Nhưng mà khi mình normalize thì cái điểm ở chỗ này nó vẫn phải cao hơn cái điểm ở chỗ này. Nhìn trên slide, ví dụ như cái số 1 là em cho cái điểm nó cao hơn cái số 2 thì khi em normalize thì cái điểm nó vẫn phải cao hơn là nó mới đúng, chứ em normalize mà em cho nó thấp hơn là nó bị sai. Normalize chẳng qua là mình
dạ vâng đúng rồi ạ.
Thì mình phải check lại cái yếu tố đó coi thử đúng hay sai. Okay, any other question? So what about Lynn?
Yes, I'm clear, teacher.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, I think we are run out of time. So if you have any questions, you can upload in the room, the MS Team room. So I will give you, I will respond. So I think it's today we end the class right now. I'll see you in next class. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Miss. Goodbye.
Goodbye, teacher.
Goodbye.